A judge is refusing to keep the names of alleged clients confidential in the case of a former Zumba instructor charged with prostitution in Kennebunk. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The two people at the center of the case, Alexis Wright and Mark Strong Sr., appeared in a Cumberland County courtroom today. News 8's Paul Merrill was there and he joins us now live from Portland with the latest. Paul.
Tracy, the judge refused to sign a confidentiality order that would have kept the names of the alleged clients in this case secret until the case goes to trial. Also today in court, the prosecution says that one of the computers it seized from Mark Strong's home may have some other illegal material on it. In court together for the first time today, the Zumba instructor and insurance agent who police say ran a prostitution business out of this Kennebunk storefront. Mark Strong Sr. indicted on 59 counts, including promoting prostitution.
Not guilty.
Alexis Wright indicted on 109 counts, including engaging in prostitution.
Not guilty.
Prosecutors hauled boxes of evidence into court today. Strong's lawyer, Dan Lilly, says York County and state attorneys have been dragging their feet when it comes to sharing their evidence.
They've taken a case, a small case, they've blown it into to a nightmare, but they're not prepared to go forward on it. They don't have the resources they claim. They don't seem to have the abilities.
Prosecutors say they've seized more than 100 hours of video.
It's so much that it couldn't just be readily copied onto a DVD or CD and provided to Mr. Lilly. It's that much information.
The judge sided with the defense, calling the prosecution's behavior unacceptable and scheduled a hearing about the evidence for next Thursday. Prosecutors also said today that an analysis of a computer seized from Strong shows it may contain child pornography. However, no one is charged with anything related to child porn in this case. Dan Lilly says there's no truth to this new claim.
There's no child pornography in this case. They told me that personally, they emailed it to me, and they put it in a pleading in court. And now they seem to be saying they want to go back and see what's going on. As I said before, they don't know what the hell they're doing.
We know that police have begun the process of issuing summonses to the alleged clients in this case, although as of right now, nothing has been filed in court, so none of those names are being made public right now. The judge today said that the prosecution needs to pick up the pace on this case, and she said that she'd like to start talking by the end of the month about when to schedule the date for this trial to begin. Live in Portland tonight, Paul Merrill, News 8.